This is the second video in a video series about information literacy and is presented by the Charles T. Jones Leadership Library at Central Penn College. In this video, you will learn how to identify the nature and extent of an information need. The very first part of this step is identifying what information is needed to satisfy your topic or research question. Can you articulate not only the research question, but also the information you need to obtain, but don't have in your possession yet? If the answer is no, then here's what you should do. First, ask questions to your professor or other experts, as well as other students. Also, continually question your own work. Second, formulate your thesis statement. Write it down. Refine it until it is clear and succinct. A thesis statement should be only one or two sentences long. Next, explore general information sources. Credo and Opposing Viewpoints are two of the library's online resources that provide general information organized into topic pages. You might need to change your topic or research question based on the information you learn. Your topic might be too broad or too narrow. There might not be any published studies that would answer your research question. Through exploration, you might find that you're more interested in a related topic. Finally, make note of some keywords that you notice are repeated. These keywords will help you search. Are you able to identify what types of information sources will be most helpful to your specific research question or topic? Since we now live in a digital world, information sources can be found in a wide variety of formats. Some traditional types of sources include print books, newspapers, and magazines. However, those items can now be found in a digital format as well. Other sources include DVDs, digital streamable films, and datasets. Journal articles are another type of source, one that you will become familiar with during your time at Central Penn. It will be important to be able to identify who the target audience is of each source you are perusing. Some sources are meant for the general public. Other audiences might include professionals working in a particular field. As you advance into higher level courses at Central Penn, it will be vital that you choose sources that are targeting experts in the field you are pursuing. Primary sources are historical records of a topic or an event taking place. Examples include photographs of an event, an account written by a person who witnessed an event, or historical newspaper or magazine articles. Original research, statistics, and data are also considered primary sources, as are government-created documents. Secondary sources examine and incorporate primary sources. Secondary sources include scholarly books and articles. Primary sources are often preferred in an academic environment. However, there are many times when a secondary source is appropriate to use for your research as well. Not all information is free or easily accessible. Are you able to identify what information is free to access? First, you'll need to know what information is free to you. As a Central Penn College student, many online scholarly resources are included with your tuition. You can access these resources in the Library tab in Blackboard. The World Wide Web also has billions of web pages for you to explore, but not all of them are free. You will have to determine if you are willing to pay to receive access to information. If so, you should establish a budget for access to resources. You should also develop a research timeline so you can plan when you will search certain sources, when you will write your paper, and make sure to leave room to edit and revise your paper before submitting it for grading. If you have questions about identifying an information need, contact the library.